Hi, I'm Mark Renshaw and welcome to the finale, and we're here for stage one of the Giro d'Italia, the Gran Partenza, out of Budapest to Vinograd. Stage one, 195 kilometers. Nothing too exceptional in this stage, but what a final we have in store for us. 5 kilometer climb, who's going to be able to make it? Can the sprinters get up there, or is it going to be one of the favorites as a puncher to take the victory today? Here we are, we're coming into the approach to the final climb, and it is Caleb Ewan who has his team on the front. They've put him in perfect position into this crucial corner that starts the climb. He wants to start in the front, he wants to be able to hide in the wheels, save some of that energy for the final climb. Caleb Ewan here holding perfect position. We can see him inside the top four riders, just following the moves. He's up on the hoods, riding a nice tempo, not overgeared, staying in position. Richard Carapaz hard on the wheel. We look a little bit further back, we can see Gourmet followed by Vanderpool. He knows the wheel that he wants to be in for this final. Inside the final 400 meters, and it is Bora Hansgrohe who launched the first attack for the finish line. They're all in, they're committed. Caleb Ewan sitting pretty third wheel. As we round the second last bend, we can see that Gourmet, he commits to going early for the finish line. Vanderpool in the wheel. As they approach the last bend, Gourmet all in. Vanderpool sees the line. Caleb Ewan doesn't really have anywhere to go. Switches across over to Gourmet's wheel. Vanderpool committed. He's passed. Vanderpool takes the win from Gourmet. Caleb Ewan going down in that final bend. Now let's have a look at how Caleb Ewan crashed in that final of the stage. All that blame, it rests on his shoulders. That's now two times in the Grand Tour that in the first stage, he's crashed with inside of the finish line. As we dive into the final, we can see that Gourmet starts his sprint. He goes from a long way out, maybe a little bit too far, but there's nothing to lose. He's committed to the final here. He believes he has the legs. We can see Vanderpool half a length off the back of Gourmet. He knows he's just got to follow that wheel and duck out at the last moment, especially on a finish like this. With a climb, it's always difficult. You need to leave it to the last moment. Gourmet go, he sees the line. Caleb Ewan pops up the inside of court. He's got the space there, and he's also got the fastest line to the finish. Up the inside on the barriers, it's always dangerous. We see Gourmet puts his head down. He drifts to the right. Caleb Ewan falls into the wheel of Gourmet. Vanderpool, he's committed to the finish line. He can see it. He knows he's got that little bit extra speed as he's come off the wheel of Gourmet. We can see here, Gourmet, he just slows. He sees Vanderpool checks towards him on the barrier. Caleb Ewan hard on the wheel, obviously giving 110%. He's hard on the wheel. He doesn't really have place to move. He's not going that much faster than Gourmet, but he's running at the back of him. Vanderpool steps across to the right. It just balks Gourmet. He loses momentum. He can see the victory sliding away, and this is where it all goes wrong for Caleb Ewan. Gourmet losing that touch of speed. Caleb Ewan going that little bit faster. He overlaps the wheel to the right side, crashes hard on his left side, and he doesn't get the chance to finish third on the stage. Would have been a great start for Caleb in such a difficult final. He wasn't a chance to take the victory, but he was definitely up there for third place. That's not how you want to start the Giro d'Italia. He doesn't look too bad. He's not happy with himself. He knows that mistake falls on his shoulders. He just had nowhere to go, overlapped the wheel, and went down with only 25 meters to go in the race.